my friend at AOC, Father Rodolfo F, Willmann, Charities Department, for inviting me inside for the open commemorating the 37th death anniversary of Veteran Father Rodolfo J. Willmann this day, and to be the witness for this occasion. May God forgive you of your cross. However, my acceptance to the invitation is my humble way of reiterating once again my gratitude for the scholarship, the legacy that granted to me as a priest in pursuit of spatial studies in Rome. Father George Willmann was among the many qualities of his reverend, a philanthropist, Jesuit, teacher, priest. After reading a couple of books of him, I must admit that I was awed by how big his heart was for others, and especially for Filipinos. Born to a deeply religious and practicing Catholic family in New York City, his parents had trained their children to pray together go to Mass every Sunday, and brought them to Catholic school. When they were growing up, the Willmann children met in my class. It was the best way of teaching their children to do missions. The children were asked to sacrifice a meal, to give up everything, in order to put the money into the money box for the business. This early initiative of giving for the poor is philanthropy's spirit that paved the way for Father George to welcome the call to become a missionary. Receiving occasion of celebration is a gift from the Lord, that it may come to a person, a young man, directly, that God calls him, or through instrumentality of other people, an anthropist, a sister, a knight of Columbus, or that matter. And so, these are people, instruments for them to respond to the call of God. In my days, I remember when I was a little boy, I used to see my mother early in the morning, knitting down for our family to call for. I was a Christian, and so I went. Referring to the images that he was addressing in the prayer school. And the only answer I could get was to be quiet. And he had done. Father George proceeded to the Jesuit high school in Brooklyn. Education was serious. And he admired the Jesuit scholastic substance. He was then inspired to become a Jesuit. He was an athlete, besides his interest in dramatics and journalism. Before he entered the Jesuit lodging, St. Andrew's for that accident. He worked on Lord's Day for 4 years as a messenger boy from 1930 to 1915. His training in the Jesuit school in Albuquerque prepared him well to his apostolic letter on the Philippines. He was focused on two things. First, the education of the land, and second, the equipment of the poor from the poverty. His early assignments as a treasurer in all the world Jesuit schools and missions in the Philippines, making a financial missionary himself. Father George remained in the Philippines for the first time in 1922 and stayed here until 1925. He was assigned a region and teacher at Adenio went back to the U.S. to continue his priestly formation. He studied philosophy and theology at Woodstock in Manila, a renowned and excellent seminary formation for the Jesuits. After his ordination on June 20, 1928, Father George was assigned working both with the church and with the school. He did a lot of fundraising for the Jesuit missionaries in the Philippines. He was an excellent Jesuit priest, particularly concerned with the poor.
November 36, 1936,
John Lyman from Leading Professor, Treasurer, Monthly Editor of the Ateneo School Organ. He was first introduced to the Intramuros Council 1000, the only council in the Philippines at the time. The KOC was established in 1905 by everyone Irish American military with the American Patriot. The Filipino Nazi took over the organization in 1918. Most of them associated with the Ateneo in Manila. The International Eucharistic Congress was held in Manila in 1947. Upon the request of the Archbishop of Manila, Father George was assigned marshal of the celebrations. He coordinated well with the national nobles in leading the preparations of the big event of the country. The following year, in 1958, he was unanimously chosen as the chaplain of the Manila Plans Economies. Father George left the first grand impression that the Knight of Columbus was an organization established as an counterattack against nation, against Antibionism and Protestantism, against lawlessness of bandits and brothers. Have been organized to defend our faith. The Knights of Columbus were the defense force of the Catholic Church. But Father George had seen something more. He was so edified with the Knights of Columbus campaign against poverty. He felt the pain of his generous response to the call of charity. Those blessed with the world's truth should share this with the poor. The joy of encountering the simple, the humble, in the farthest places, like the one I mentioned to you, I answer, the love which is God. Then, my dear friend, even as a teacher, God inspired me to love the poor. There is true joy in sharing with the poor, as shown to us by Father Willmann. Such is the joy of doing. Father George was not only a chaplain of the KOC Council on Hapsan. The organization responded well to the Holy Father's funding on Catholic action. The organization led the lady to actively participate in the apostolate of the hierarchy. It has earlier the spirit of the Central Government Council in involving the lady in the life and mission of the Church. I would like to understand that he has led the Filipino Catholic Faith in the Philippines to the spirit of the Central Government Council, which trusts his participation in both in the life and activities of the Church. It has strengthened the devotion to Colombian ideals, the Colombian fraternity among brothers. The KOC has actively cooperated with the missions in peace. thus demonstrating its unity, charity, patriotism, and truly Colombian apostolic spirit. Father George J. Willmann is a Jesuit priest who has served the Filipino people in various capacities as a teacher, and the people have been the guidance counselor of the youth. More significantly, he had demonstrated an unparalleled dedication as a Philippine deputy of the Knights of Columbus for almost 40 years. He had faithfully defended and guided the growth of the Knights of Columbus in the Philippines, an increase from 35 to 457 counselors. He has spent the best years of the life in the service of the Knights of Columbus, devoting all his efforts and energy in promoting the ideas and principles of the order. Now, witness today the fruit of his labor, the tremendous growth of the association in our country, beginning by the friends of the Knights with yourselves. You are the living witnesses that Father George Willmann has not died, but continues to be. He is very present in our minds. The Lord said, I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me, birds must come. For apart from me, you can do nothing. Father George Willmann has borne so much fruit to us in the mission in the Philippines because he had abided in Christ our Lord. It is because he is the Lord that he had proclaimed to us and not himself. Such was his humility and love as a disciple of the Lord. And so the Knights of Columbus will only continue to try if, like our Master and Honorable Father, Father George, we would abandon in the love of Christ, our Lord, and the service of his beloved God. The works of charity that we continue to do, the scholarship that we continue to give out to the needy, the livelihood programs, the financial assistances, and especially the peace assessment for the Philippines, and many more. This our Latin do them in the name of God. The mission that we are doing is only a self-expression of the baptismal mission that we share in the threefold mission of Christ. In this year of the Lady, therefore, we are more privileged to know and discover the depth of the meaning of your Christian mission to be priest, prophet, and king. Every one of us share the common priesthood of Christ. We are here to sanctify this world that we live in by our prayers, by our lives. Secondly, we do our prophets as Christ our head. As individuals and as a church, we have promised in our baptism to reject Satan and all his hidden temptations. We have also promised to believe in one God who is Lord power that the pleasure stood us to be able to be a prophet is to know sin. Many rejected in our lives. It is to know evil. Many expelled from our society. The third of this beautiful vision is that completely we are called to serve others in charity and love, just as the kings of the Old Testament have been appointed. Kings before were the watchers of the city. They were the caretakers of the people. They come to the aid of those who are poor and in need. Kings were appointed to show the face of God through their concern for others. The charitable works of the lives of the most are outward signs and perpetrations of Christ's humanity. What a privilege to thank the Lord for so much of this to us. And as we continue celebrating this humanity, bear in mind the spirit of Father George Beltran, who has left this task to us of continuing the service of God in the world, of being dedicated to nice purpose, of being true men of God, and of being